Hey guys, do you remember the song Shotgun from George Ezra? Yeah, probably, because it's not been that long, but have you seen the music video? Now, I find it one of the better music videos that I've ever seen, and since the moment that it came out, I was very intrigued by it. Basically, this was shot using a motion-controlled robot arm that would literally rotate around a platform. Pretty crazy. Now, over the years here at Cinecom, we've been trying to recreate it. We once came very close when we built this camera train, but it had the limitation of not being motion controlled, and we should have built a platform as well to be able to go underneath the plane. So, back to the drawing board, and without fancy equipment, it's nearly impossible to make. Unless we downscale the setup. So this right here is the thing that I've been working on yesterday, which is just a simple U-form, which I've built out of wooden planks. Through there, you can see that I've drilled two holes, and in the middle of the pipe that goes through it, we have this box that I've built out of Legos. Now, the way that we've made this motion controlled is through the HeadOne of Edelkrone, which is this thing right here. I'll leave a link to it in the description down below. But basically, this is a unit to motion control a camera, but we've DIY'd it into attaching it to this structure, which is now controlling this middle bar right here, which I can control with my app. Check it out. It's rotating right now, the platform. Pretty cool, right? So what we just do is let it make several turns with some kind of a scenery on it, then take a shot of that, swap the scenery with something else, and make again a shot of that, let it rotate, etc. Now, if you don't have one of these HeadOnes, you can also try and figure out something else, like use a drill, although that will go pretty fast. Unless you want to have like a fast rotating scenery, you know, then you can use that. But it has to be motion controlled, super important. Now, before we continue, I'd first like to thank Skillshare for their support today. As you know, we are among the top teachers and have a bunch of classes on Skillshare and really enjoy the platform and its community. But apart from our filmmaking classes, you can find tens of thousands of other classes. For instance, I recently followed Nguyen on Nguyen's class about how to get the blockbuster look on a DIY budget. He covers how to start with a single idea and then build out a mood board out of your vision for art direction and visual effects. And the workflow he teaches is very interesting and definitely opened my eyes. You know, for example, he started with a single picture of a look that he liked, which he used to find a location and then with post-production matched that location even more to the picture. Now, the way he breaks down a reference photo is really amazing and very inspiring. It's a short class with a ton of information, like most classes on Skillshare, which is something that I really like as I don't have much time to sit through long courses. So, this is definitely a class that I can recommend to check out. The first 500 people to sign up through the first link in the description down below receive 2 months for free access to Skillshare, and after that is a very low price of less than $10 per month. This gives you access to all the classes on Skillshare, kind of like the Netflix principle. So go check it out right now, and I hope to see you there. But first, let's check out the post-production. We ended up with a bunch of clips of a rotating platform. For starters, we can key out the green screen of all the clips and, if necessary, mask away anything that shouldn't be there. Then align the clips in such a way that one sits on top and the other one on the bottom. They should now roll perfectly in sync together, and this is why that motion controller was so important. On the point where they come together, I'm actually going to create a mask on the top clip through the middle and feather that a bunch. When the second clip is covering the back entirely, I add a cut, then move the clip down and remove that mask. Next, place a third clip on top, create that feathered mask through the platform, add a cut when it sits vertical, push it down, and then remove the mask. Continue doing this for as many clips that you have. And finally, just like last week's video, I'm going to search for a 360 stock clip and place that on the bottom of the timeline. Now, using the GoPro's free plugin called Reframe, we can animate that 360 background so that it feels like the camera is rotating around the platform instead of the platform rotating itself. And when you're done with that, we can select everything in the timeline and choose Nest to group it all together. And this gives you one clip on which we can add a time remapping and have our own shotgun-inspired music video. But then, miniature. And that was it! I hope that you liked the end result, it was pretty fun to make. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Skillshare, for the support. And as always, stay creative.
So I love playing around with all of this Lego, but since I'm colorblind, I have to sort everything per color so I don't make any mistakes while making these sceneries. And I think I'm doing a good job. What do you think?
You know what's the worst? He's color grading this shot.